Okay, today we will continue our new chapter. New chapter of discrete and continuous random variable. Generally, a variable such as the strength of a concrete or any other material or physical quantity whose values is uncertain or unpredictable or non-deterministic is called a random variable or a variate if its distribution is known. Okay, that is a proper definition, but generally to remember, in previous chapter we find the probability of certain events and these events having certain characteristic or property. On that basis, now we will define our variable. Our variable will have certain characteristic or property or a thing which is under consideration. We will define a variable for that. There are two types of variables, discrete and continuous. In first section, we will study discrete random variables, and in second step, we will discuss continuous random variable. So, a discrete random variable can assume at most a countable set of isolated values as already stated, such as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or in the form of a sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, or 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 5 by 7, in fraction and also in decimal. In all of these sets, one thing is common, that there is a gap between any two consecutive values. That is called a random variable, discrete random variable. In discrete random variable, the values may be integral in the form of a sequence, in the form of fraction, or in decimal even. But every two consecutive values have a gap. They are separate. They are isolated. It doesn't matter they are infinite or finite. They have a gap, so they are called discrete. The countable and also isolated meaning are also the same. Countable may be finite or infinite. Isolated means they are having gaps. The probability distribution function for a discrete random variable will be called as a probability mass function. The role of this probability mass function is to find the probability for each value of x. The characteristics, further the characteristics for this probability mass functions are just like the probability that the probability of probability, or you can say the value of a probability mass function at a particular value is always between 0 and 1, and total probability is equal to 1. As we have discussed this example, in which three coins are tossed, we have the sample space. In this case, when we have all the three outcomes tail, one head and two tails, two heads, one tail, and all the three heads. We are familiar with this sample space. So now in this section, in this study, in this chapter, we will define, as we are defining certain variable, so we can also define a certain variable on this sample space having certain characteristics. So let our variable X denotes the number of heads. So this is the thing we need to study. This is the thing under discussion. So we denote this consideration by X. So obviously the range of this consideration is 0, 1, 2, and 3. 0 means 0 head. So there is only one favorable case out of 8. So this is the probability for X equal to 0. X equal to 1 means 1 head. So there are 3 possible cases having one head. So the probability for X equal to 1 is 3 by 8. Similarly, for X equal to 2, we have 3 possible cases. So the probability for X equal to 2 is 3 by 8. X equal to 3 means all the three outcomes are the heads. Only one possibility. So 1 out of 8 is the probability for X equal to 3. Each probability is less than 1, and total probability is equal to 1. That's why this is called a complete probability distribution. Is called a complete probability distribution for X. Similarly, this is also a familiar example. When a pair of dice is thrown and we consider the sum of the dots. So X denotes the sum of the dots. Its range is from 2 to 12. As for X equal to 2 means the sum is 2. The corresponding order pairs is 1. So the probability is 1 by 36. X equal to 3 means the sum is 3. the corresponding order pairs in the sample space are 2, which are giving us some 3. So the probability for x equal to 3 is 2 by 36. X equal to 4 means the sum 4 and corresponding order pairs are 3. Therefore, the probability is 3 by 36. Similarly, we can find the probability for each value of x. Similarly, we can consider in all cases first define the variable and then find the probability for each value of x. In a manufacturing process, having a quality control program include inspection of incoming materials for defects. Suppose computer manufacturer receives computer boards in lots of 5. 2 boards are selected from each lot for inspection. We can represent possible outcomes of the selection process by pair. For example, like this. As our collection containing 5 computer chips, so from there if we select 2, we will select them in order pairs. So manufacturer knows that the board 1 and 2 in a lot of 5 are defective boards. But is the activity here, we are selecting two boards. Two boards are selected at random. So this is the activity. Suppose a board 1 and 2 are defective. So this is the situation we have. We define x, our variable, showing the number of defective boards in our selected items, in the items which are inspected. Now, what is the question? Find the probability distribution for x. We can select the boards ways. We select 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 2, 3, 2, 4, 5, 3, 4, 3, 5, 4, 5. Why they are ten in number, we are actually selecting 2 out of 5. That's why total possible cases are 5C2 equal to 10. How we construct these 10 items, these 10 possibilities as the lot contains five items. One, two, three, four, five. Now we select pairwise. Either we select 1 and 2, start from 1, keeping first component 1. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5. So we have constructed these 4 order pairs. Now start from 2. 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5. We have these 3 order pairs. Now starting from 3. 3, 4, 3, 5. Don't go reverse side. Move forward. First make the pair with 1, then with 2, then with 3, then with 4. 4 to 5. Only 1. So in this way we have 10 order pairs. If we construct a sample space like the rolling of a dice, we will have 5 by 5, 25 order pairs. But in this case, selection of 1, 2 and 2, 1 is meaningless. We will select only one pair, either 1, 2 or 2, 1. Similarly, selection of 1 and 3 is the same thing. Selection 1, 3 and 3, 1 is the same thing. Also, selection of 1, 4 and 4, 1 is the same thing. Selection of 3, 4 and 4, 3 is the same thing. And what about the order pair having same components? 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5. The selection of 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5 is the meaningless, because we are selecting 2. We are selecting pairwise. We cannot select 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5. Now we have constructed our sample space, and also we have defined our variable. So what is the probability for x equal to 0? Means zero defective. And we know that board 1 and 2 are the defective boards. So this is the only order pair which is having zero defective. The order pair having zero defective. It is neither containing 1 nor containing 2. So that's why the probability for x equal to 0 is, also we have this order pair which is containing neither 1 or nor 2. Also we have this one. So there are 3 order pairs which are having no defective item. So the probability for x equal to 0 is 3 by 10. For x equal to 1, these are the order pairs, these 6 order pairs having either 1 or 2, not the both, either having 1 or 2. So 6 order pairs are there which are having exactly 1 defective. So the probability for x equal to 1 is 6 by 10. And there is one order pair having both defective, 1 and 2. So the probability for x equal to 2 is 1 out of 10. So this is again a complete probability distribution. Also try this one, the probability function. For x equal to 1, our variable having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. five possible values and their probability is given. That means a probability distribution function is given. Find the probability of this requirement. Also, we have a probability then mass function for a variable with this range. Our variable in this case in values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So, what is the probability for x equal to 0? Put x equal to 0 in this probability mass function. What is the value for x equal to 1? Put x equal to 1 in this probability mass function. Similarly, we can find the probability for each value of x. We need to find, first of all, we need to calculate the value of k. Because without finding the value of k, we cannot get an exact value of the probability. So first we find k, or we find by considering total probability equal to 1. Total probability is equal to 1. So on the left hand side, this is our function, sum up this function, which is equal to 1. As this function is a probability function, and to 2, we are getting k over 2 power 2. So we have a k term with each value. So keeping k common from all, we get this. Or otherwise, first mention here, k by 2. Power 2, k by 2 power 3. Now taking k common, solve this series inside the brackets. This is a perfect geometric series whose first term is 1 and common ratio is 1 by 2. And we know the sum of an infinite geometric series is A over 1 minus R. Sum of this infinite geometric series, the answer is 1 over 1 minus 1 by 2. 1 minus 1 by 2 is again 1 by 2. So we have 1 over 1 by 2 means 2 is equal to 1 by 2. Try to simplify and try to apply the geometric series formula. So finally we have our probability mass function of this form by putting the value of k. Now we are able to find the probability for each value of x. But our requirement is to find the probability for x greater or equal to 4. Greater or equal to 4 means we will find the probability, sum of the probability x equal to 4 for x equal to 5, x equal to 6, and so on. Again, we have a geometric series whose first term is 1 over 2 power 5 and common ratio is 1 by 2. So apply the formula of to sum up infinite geometric series and get the answer. As we are now discussing random variables and they have numeric values, therefore we will also have their mean and variance. Each value of x having certain probability, so we find the mean of these random variables on the basis of probability. So the mean of x is denoted by E of x is called the expectation, mathematical expectation. How we find it? We multiply each value of x with the corresponding probability and sum up. This is the formula now for the expectation. This expectation of x is called the mean of x. Is there any question? जी कोई क्वेश्चन है तो पूछ लेंगे। इन फर्स्ट लाइन वी हैव मेंशन्ड दैट मीन और एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू ऑफ अ रैंडम वेरिएबल ऑफ एक्स डिनोटेड बाय ई ऑफ एक्स दिस इज the mean of x, and this mean is actually the weighted mean of all of its possible values. How the weighted mean? They are weighted by the respective probabilities. Just like the weighted mean. How we find the weighted mean? We multiply each value of x with the corresponding weightage. Now the weightage here in this case is the probability. So we multiply each value of x with the corresponding probability. Similarly, the variance is the expected value of x minus mu square, the expected value of x minus mu square. How is it defined? We multiply each value of x minus mu square by putting the values of x. We get different squares. So multiply each square with the corresponding probability and sum up. So we also have an alternative formula. Alternative formula for the variance. That the variance of x is equal to expected value of x square minus square of the expected value of x. So remember these formulas for mean and variance of x. For example, two new product designs are to be compared on the basis of revenue potential. Marketing feels that the revenue from design A can be predicted quite accurately to be $3 million. The revenue potential of design B is more difficult to assess. Marketing concludes that there is a probability of 0.3 for the revenue from design B. Will be 7 million, but there is 0.7 probability that the revenue will be only 2 million from the other design. Which design do you prefer? Now let X denotes the revenue from design A, because there is no uncertainty in the revenue from design A. We can model the distribution of the random variable X as 3 million with probability 1. Therefore, expected value of X is 3 million. Y denotes the revenue from design B. Expected value Y in millions of dollars is expected value of Y multiply 7 dollars with the corresponding probability. Multiply a second amount with the corresponding probability and sum up. This is the average of Y. This is the expected value of Y. Now, because expected value of Y exceeds expected value of X, we might prefer design B. However, the variability of the result from design B is larger. How we assess the variability? By calculating the variance by the formula mentioned above. We get 5.25. Standard deviation is 2.29 by taking positive square root. Okay, this was just to know the purpose of the mean and variance of X. To discuss the variability, to compare the expected values, to compare the mean values for better decision, we apply these things. But you have to go through all these problems where we find expected value of X and the variance. This is your work at the moment. We have variable with value 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, and 2 with this probability. Quickly calculate the mean and variance. Mean is the expected value of X and variance is using alternative formula. How can we calculate expected value? By multiplying each value with the corresponding probability and sum up. The answer is 1. Okay. Now, to use the formula for the variance, first calculate expected value of X square. How we calculate? Multiply square of X. square of each value of x with the corresponding probability. First value is 0, 0 square with the corresponding probability, 1 square with the corresponding probability, 2 square with the corresponding probability, and sum up. This is giving expected value of x square. Put all them, all these values in the formula. Expected value of x square we just have calculated as 3 by 2, and expected value of x we have calculated as 1. So 3 by 2 minus 1 square. And simplifying, we get the answer 1 by 2. Similarly, also go through the this probability distribution. Find the mean and variance. Now we have some more problems in which we can assess the expectation. Expectation having its usual meaning, how do we expect? How is the expectation with our profit, with our loss, for our business, for our construction? So expectation having the usual meaning. But we calculate this mathematically. For example, if it rains, an umbrella salesman can earn $30 per day. If the day is fair, he will lose $6. So what is his expectation about his business? So in this way, we can decide whether we should launch our business in a particular region or not. We can decide for any project whether to launch or not. Because in this area, the probability of rain is 30% per day. This means the probability for not raining is 0.7. This is the probability when it rains, and this is the probability when the day is fair. So multiply this probability, this amount with 0.3, and loss we denote with negative sign. So minus 6 with 0.7, and sum up. What is the answer in this case? Simply, our possible values of x are 30 dollars and 6 dollars due to loss. Therefore, expected value of x is multiply 30 with 0.3 and minus 6 with 0.7. Simplify. The answer in dollars. We have the units of the mean and variance according to the units of x. So this will be our answer. In second example, a coin is biased, means the probability of a head and the tail are not the same. How is it biased? A head is 3 times as likely to occur as the tail. The probability of a head is 3 times than that of a tail. So if the probability of a tail is W, this means the probability of the head is 3W and total is equal to 1. This means this means 4W is equal to 1. W is equal to 1 by 4. Hence, probability of a Now, before finding the probability, obviously, we have the probability of a tail is 1 by 4 and probability of a head is 3 by 4. But we should define this probability according to your variable. And variable is defined whatever is under consideration. Here in this case, we need to find the expected number of the tails. So this is our variable. X denotes the number of tails. Therefore, the values of X in this activity is 0 and 1. Possibly, we may have 0 tail or 1 tail. What is the corresponding probability? Probability of X equal to 0 is 0 means 0 tail. X equal to 0 is the probability for 0 tail. This means this is the probability of a head, which is 3 by 4. Similarly, the probability for X equal to 1 means 1 tail, which we have calculated 1 by 4. So multiply each value of X with the corresponding probability. Now you will get the answer, expected value of X. So this should be the focus. Remember, first of all, you have to define your variable, its range, and then the corresponding probability. If you need to calculate the expectation, multiply each value of X with the corresponding probability and sum up. Now here, we have another example. A man draw 2 balls from a bag containing 3 white and 5 black balls. He is receiving $70 for every white he draws, and he is getting $7 for each black ball. Find his expectation about his winning amount. So first of all, we should mention our variable. X denotes the winning amounts. So the possible values of x are depending upon the draws. So a man can draw two balls. In three possible ways. Either both white. Say event A. What is the probability of this event to get both white? Total we have three white and five black balls, and total we have eight balls. So the probability to get both white, first white 3/8, second white 7. So this is the probability of A. But is the case to case two, one white and one black. This is the event. What is the probability of B? One white, first white, 3/8, second black, 5/7, or 5/8. 3/7, because if our selection is containing one white and one black, we may have first white, second black, or first black and second white. In the same way, we will find the probability or use the combination rule. If we use combination formula, there is no need to consider all the possible cases. Favorable cases, just calculate favorable cases divided by total possible cases. What is our third case? When we have both black. Event C, and what is the probability first black 5/8, second black and black 4/7. Now, if X denotes the winning amounts, so in how many possible ways we can win the amount, depending upon these cases, if we are getting both white, we will win $140. $140. If we are getting one white and one black, we will get $77. If we are getting both black, we will get $14. Now, we can find the expected value of X, because now we have to simply multiply each value with the corresponding probability. Multiply 77 with this probability, multiply 14 with this probability, and sum up. Multiply each value of X with the corresponding probabilities and sum up. This will be the expectation of person for his winning amounts. Similarly, check these examples also. Now take a break of 5 minutes. We will continue from these distribution. Now we have distribution in previous. Up till now, we have discussed random variables and also we have constructed their probability distributions. But now we have certain probability distributions by name, well-known probability distributions like Bernoulli, binomial, Poisson, and others. Their probability functions are known. So easily we can find the probability for their random variables. Let's have a break, then we will discuss. At 9:15.